guys are certainly excited to kind of wash the taste out from last week to get going. And it means a lot to be able to do it at the Shrine Game. That's a pretty special event for us, and it means more than just, you know, Beaver football or, you know, particularly doing some of the, you know, just the X's and O's. You're doing it for a bigger cause. So I think the guys understand that they're pretty fortunate to be able to play this game, and there's a lot of people less fortunate than them. So it's always nice to partner with the Shrine Game and certainly get back on the field and get the ball rolling for our side of the, or for our team as well. You know, as much as I want to say we need to do this or do that, I think it's more of what we need to control on our own side is we need to just play fast on offense and play physical and tackle better on defense and really just take care of the special teams battle. So they do have some good players. They certainly got a good receiving core. They got good running backs, just like everybody in this league. They're going to have good players on defense too. They got a really good defensive line, a couple different defensive linemen that are really good football players. So I think for us, though, it's just, hey, get back to doing what we do, and hopefully that will help take care of everything in terms of the game. Yeah, you have to. I mean, you got to play week to week and almost down to down in this conference. Every single team that you play can beat you. And you got to be able to step up and improve. And I think anytime from week one to week two, it's where you expect to see big improvements from your team, and no different than us. We had quite a few guys that took some, you know, new positions or new reps or hadn't been on the field quite as much in different roles. So those guys are now veterans, and they need to improve and continue to move forward and excel. So my expectation is to just go out and play football, take a deep breath and have fun with it and play fast and physical, and that's what we're planning to do. It's just that. You got to put it behind you. I mean, if you get stuck in the past, just like in life, you're going to continue to dwell on it, and it's going to affect your future. So you can't really dwell on anything. You had that opportunity's gone, and now we need to be able to do our part to help clean up the solution. And the solution to the problem last week and moving forward is just play better football and play Beaver football. So that's what we've been talking about with the guys, and that's what we need to be able to do. Yeah, I mean, we'll take whatever the defense is going to give us. I mean, we think we can throw the ball if they're low in the box, and if vice versa, we have to be able to run the ball if it's light, box count, whatever. And you know, staying on your blocks a little bit longer, understanding what they're doing. It's hard your first game. You think you know what your opponents are going to do, and then they do something different, so you're making a lot of in-game adjustments. I think we have a pretty good grasp of what CSP is going to try to do defensively and offensively the same. And they're going to have wrinkles. Everybody's going to have wrinkles. But for the most part, seeing what you're going to get and now being able to go out and practice that for a little bit of extended, you know, period of time since the game was last Thursday. So we're excited to just get back out there and show our fans what we can do. I think it just went down to some real base things. We handled our front seven played well. We handled the run game particularly well against Winona, which we were, you know, we thought they were going to do, and they hit some big plays. I think you look back on film, you know, they had 370 yards total offense, but 150 of that really came on just a select few handful of plays. So if we can improve not giving up big plays in the pass game, which some of them were jump balls, some 50-50 balls, which CSP is going to do, you'll see a very good receiver. They got a big 6'5 outside receiver that they're going to chuck it up to. He's got good ball skills. So that's what we need to be able to do is pressure the quarterback, stop the run, and then go up and battle on 50-50 balls and not be an 80-20 ball type deal where they're coming down with the vast majority. We always talk about controlling the line of scrimmage, and I've been here a long time. That's been my calling card is stop the run, stop the run, stop the run. And we feel that we have an extremely good defensive front seven, and so we're going to lean on those guys and make sure that we get, you know, hats in the right spots. It's just a fit issue, just making sure guys are in the right spot. They do some creative things on offense that's going to be a little bit different than what you saw last week. It was a little bit more traditional. This week it's kind of like our offense. They're going to run the quarterback. They'll run, you know, different option looks, if you would look at it that way, RPO scheme, run pass option. So we'll have to defend in a different way, which I think we're pretty good at. We see that quite often from our own offense. So we should be okay in terms of slowing down their run. We just can't give up big runs. And last week they had a 60-yard run and a couple really big runs in the second half where they made some really good in-game adjustments against Minot State. So we'll have to make sure that we're on top of the changes and see what they want to try to do against us.
It's always awesome to play home, get to play in front of the home crowd, people's parents, families, friends, classmates. You know, it's always good to play home. Just looking forward to bounce back. Got to bounce back. You know, it's always tough to take an L, but unfortunately, it's part of sports, so we're going to see how we bounce back. Definitely a huge confidence booster. You know, it's always easier to play in front of home. We practice there every day. You're familiar with the turf, familiar with the stadium, you know. So that's always the positive. Definitely one game at a time, one game at a time. You know, it's a long season, play 11 games. Got to take each game one step at a time, one play at a time. I guess statistically we had a good game, but we know we could have played better as an offense. So definitely got to get the running game going more. Got to get Tahi, Mikey Washington, Drew, they all got to get in there, get some carries, get some yards, and then that'll open up the pass game for us. They have a really good D-line. So if our O-line is able to protect, run block, I think we'll be all right. Definitely just getting plays faster, lining up, making sure everyone's on the same page, receivers relaying the play to the other receiver, halfbacks replaying the play to the offensive line, and so everyone's on the same page so we can go as fast as possible. That's big time. Blair Vanesse is a great receiver. You know, he's going to end up helping us in the long run. Gives us depth between me, him, Christian Lundy, Brad Birchfield, a couple other receivers we got, Jake Anderson. And if everyone can step up and play the role, we'll be okay.
Yeah, it's great to be home. It'll be nice playing the home turf, back at the Ched, get the boys going a little bit and kind of reroute from last week and get to play in front of our home fans and kind of get the ball rolling here. We really had Winona schemed up. Obviously, we did really well against the run. It's just we missed opportunities in the secondary with jump balls. I mean, last week, I think it was, I don't know how many times the receiver tipped it up and we just didn't come down with it. So, I mean, we look to improve a lot in the secondary and just continue to shut teams down in the run. So we're really not trying to get down on ourselves. We just look back at the film, understand the mistakes we made, and just continue to build off that and just get ready to go. Yeah, you got to respect that, but I think, debatably, I'd say we have the best run defense in the conference, so we're just going to scheme them up, run our stuff, and just continue to do what we do in the box. Yeah, they got a really talented kid on the outside, and you obviously got to respect that, so we got to scheme some stuff up for him. But we're just going to continue to play our style of football and just keep going with the way we do.